Good evening everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about the measurement of three wire method. Okay, so in this method, measurement of three wire method, we are using as three wires. Okay, we are going to keep the three wires over here. The distance between these two cylinders is h, between the the diameter, the effective diameter is E. So normally with the help of this two wire method and three method wire method, we are going to measure the effective diameter. Okay, so the V pieces are used to measuring the minor diameter are replaced by steel wires or cylinder. These wires made by hardened steel and sustained wear and tear in use. Okay, the three wire method is most accurate method measurement of pitch diameter over here. In this case, the three wires is known as diameter are used. One wire is kept to one side, another two wires is kept in the other side. Okay, by assuming the wire touches the flank of thread, the micrometer hand will placed parallel to the thread axis. The wires are held in hand or hung from the stand of that wire can adjust themselves under the pressure of the micrometer. So here D is the diameter of the wire, E is the effective pitch diameter, and H is the diameter over wire, Y is the diameter under wire. Okay, so P is the pitch of the thread. Okay, so D is the diameter of the wire, and H is the diameter over the wire. So this is the diameter over the wire, and Y is the diameter under the wire. That means from here, that means bottom of the cylindrical one to the another one, this one. Okay, so that distance is called as Y. Okay, so here one thing we have to remember. So after placing the wires, they are going to keep the anvil, and one side there we are going to keep one wire, another side they are going to keep the two wires. Okay, the distance between over the wire is h, the distance between below the wire is y, and the effective diameter is e. Okay, so here the thing is they are going to give over here. So while explaining the problem, we are going to discuss over here. So this is the triangle they will be shown about the OGL, this one. So OGL. Okay, another triangle it will be shows as a NIK. So another triangle there is showing as a NIK. So NIK. So this will be comes in the fundamental triangle, in this one, half of the fundamental triangle. So then comes into the sin theta is equal to OL by OG. So here sin theta is equal to OL by OG. Then comes into the OG is equal to OL by sin theta. So OG is equal to d by 2 into 1 by sin theta by 2. Okay, is equal to d by 2 sin theta by 2. So similarly consider triangle NIK. So the triangle NIK, tan theta by 2 is equal to IK by IN. So IK by IN, so opposite side by adjacent side, and IN is equal to IK by tan theta by 2. So from this IN is equal to M. So IN value is equal to M over here, and IK value is P by 2. So these things we are going to substitute into the equation. M is equal to P by 2 is into 1 by tan theta by 2. So this will become P by 2 tan theta by 2. So from the figure above B, so from the figure B, we are going to take RG is equal to M by 2. So which is the RG? So R is this one, and G. So this is the G. So RG is equal to, what is that? The distance is M by 2. So normally effective diameter exactly it will becomes middle of the thread depth. Okay, so that M is equal to, we are going to take RG by RG is equal to M by 2 we are going to take. So is equal to P by 4 tan theta by 2. Okay, so now OG is equal to OR plus RG. So in this one, OG, O, G, we are going to write down OR plus RG. Okay, so substitute the values of those one. So before therefore OR is equal to OG minus RG. So OR is equal to D by 2 sin theta by 2 minus P by 4 tan theta by 2. So from figure A and B we can write H is equal to E plus 2. Here which is the H, this is the H, we are going to write H is equal to effective diameter plus 2, that is given over here. Or we can E plus 2 into OR plus 2 OQ. Okay, so here substitute the values. H is equal to E plus 2 into D sin 2 sin theta by 2 minus P 4 tan theta by 2 into plus 2 into D by 2. Okay, so H is equal to E plus of D by sin theta by 2 minus P by 2 tan theta by 2 plus D. So now capital H is equal to capital E plus D into 1 by sin theta by 2 plus 1 minus P by 2 tan theta by 2. So H is equal to E plus D. So 1 by sin theta by 2 we can write cosecant theta by 2 minus P cot theta by 2. So now this is we are going to apply the metric thread in this formula 0.6495 P and the theta is equal to 60 degree, but the effective diameter is the major diameter minus depth of the thread. So E is equal to D minus 0.6495 P. Okay, so H is equal to D minus 0.6495 P plus D into 1 by sin 60 by 2 plus 1. So if you are simplifying this, we are getting capital H is equal to D plus 3D minus 1.5155 P. Then white box thread, for this type of thread, depth of the thread is 0.64 P, theta is equal to 55 degree, E is equal to D minus 0.64 P. If you are substituting, finally we are going to get capital H is equal to D plus 3.1656 D minus 1.6 P. So this is the formula for finding the white box thread as well as metric thread. So with the help of this three wire method, we are going to measure the effective diameter. And also the one more thing, this is the important method, or this is the effective method which can be used to measure the effective diameter. Okay, this is the three wire method. So already we have discussed two-wire method, this is the three-wire method. Next we are going to discuss about some of the gear measurements.